Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. The JPA FetchType defines when Hibernate gets the related entities from the database, and it is one of the crucial elements for a fast persistence tier. In general, you want to fetch the entities you use in your business tier as efficiently as possible. But that's not that easy. You either get all relationships with one query, or you fetch only the root entity and initialize the relationships as soon as you need them. I'll explain both approaches in more detail in this video, and I also provide you some links to more advanced solutions that combine flexibility and efficiency. When you start with Hibernate, you most likely either didn't know about fetch types, or you were told to always use fetch type lazy. In general, that's a good recommendation. But what does it exactly mean? And what is the default if you don't define the fetch type? The default depends on the cardinality of the relationship. All-to-one relationships use fetch type eager, and all-to-many relationships fetch type lazy. Even the best default doesn't fit for all use cases, and you sometimes want to change it. You can do this by providing your preferred fetch type to the relationship annotation, as you can see in the code snippet. Okay, let's get into the IDE and have a closer look at the different fetch types. The fetch type eager tells Hibernate to get all elements of a relationship when selecting the root entity. As I explained earlier, this is the default for to-one relationships, and I use it for the many-to-one relationship between the order item and the product entity. When I now fetch an order item entity from the database, Hibernate will also get the related product entity. You can see the query here. Hibernate loaded all the entities with one query. This seems to be very useful, but keep in mind that Hibernate always fetches the product entity for your order item, even if you don't use it in your business code. If the related entity isn't too big, this is not an issue for to-one relationships, but it will most likely slow down your application if you use it for a to-many relationship that you don't need for your use case. Hibernate then has to fetch tens or even hundreds of additional entities, which creates a significant overhead. The fetch type lazy tells Hibernate to only fetch the related entities from the database when you use the relationship. This is a good idea in general, but there's no reason to select entities you don't need for your use case. You can see an example of a lazily fetched relationship here. The one-to-many relationship between the order and the order item entities uses the default fetch type for to-many relationships, which is lazy. The used fetch type has no influence on the business code. You can call the getOrderItems method just as any other getter method. Hibernate handles the lazy initialization transparently and fetches the order item entities as soon as the getter method gets called. You can see the executed queries here. Hibernate selected the order entity with the first query and performed another query to load the associated order item entities. Handling lazy relationships in this way is okay if you work on a single order entity or a small list of entities. But it becomes a performance problem when you do it on a large list of entities. As you can see in the log messages, Hibernate has to perform an additional SQL statement for each order entity to fetch its order items. This behavior is called N+1 select issue, and it's the most common performance problem. It is so common that you most likely have it if you didn't explicitly search for it. If you don't know how to do that, sign up for my free 3-part video course about finding and fixing N+1 select issues. You can find a link to it in the video description. In general, there are two ways to avoid these issues. You can use FetchType eager if you know that all of your use cases that fetch an order entity also need to process the related order item entities. That will almost never be the case, so better not even think about it. If there are some use cases which only work on order entities, and that will most likely be the case, you should use FetchType lazy in your entity mapping and tell Hibernate to initialize the association within your query. There are several ways to do that, and I have shown them in great detail in a previous video. Here's the easiest one. You can use a JPQL query with a join fetch clause. That tells Hibernate to initialize the association. As you can see in the log output, Hibernate did that with the same query. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!